I do not fear the orcs, but in the deep of night, I will admit this. I fear their drums. An orc can be defeated in battle. His threat can be walled off or outmaneuvered. But the low rumbling of the drums, that cannot be halted by any artifice of man. Those drums are the heartbeat of their factories, and every beat marks the orcs' relentless advance. We seized these drums in a raid, and I locked them up in the Great Hall so that no orc could ever play them again.
Like the elves, Sauron values wisdom above all else. But for him, it is a cold, hard thing. He believes freedom is an empty virtue. He believes that Middle-earth seeks perfection in order. He believes that he will achieve what those before him could not.
Of corruption, raise their dead. Haste, haste. The stench of death surrounds. A confusion of ghouls. They rise and rise.
As they rise, so shall they fall.
Into your holes. Bury yourselves or be buried.
Talion, we must destroy the ghoul mounds. Only then will they stop.
Like this,
their bloodlust will not be sated.
Oh.
these necromancers will not stop until all the dead of Mordor have been raised.
An army to rival ours.
You almost got me, Gravewalker, but I'm wise to your ranger tricks.
Someone in the ranks has been telling you secrets, has he? That's easy enough to clean up. I'll just take the spy's tongue and your ears.
Hey!
This orc endeavors to trap us. Let us reward his cunning.
That you can't catch me!
I'll be happy to fight you instead of this beast.
You will serve the Bright Lord.
Oh, my life for you! My life for you! Sending me off, eh?
Hold it right there! It's a trap!
You will be butchered!
this weapon, Tark, and the darkness takes all the fight out of you. You'll just lie down and it'll all be over.
Cross!
Muzu.
Never met
there's a man. Let's end this.
From this place.
I wonder if its source is the butchered corpses or the butchers themselves.
Yes, master!
Chosen anyway.
They just moved over there.
Kneel before me.
Don't know! Don't know! Ah!
I don't know!
These Olaugs are pillars of the War Chief's forces. Topple them.
Send the Bright Lord!
dark.
Bullet versus man! I like my odds.
The Bright Lord is your master.
I will see your commands through.
Whatever you say, boss.
Rain of blood!
Wants you to know that he's going to enjoy killing you. Oh, and that he's going to make it hurt. A lot.
Stupid sod. Not a chance.
Well, you'll make a tasty treat for my guests.
I'll be back.
Stomach.
stampede of Uruks screaming for your blood. All standing.
Must have dropped.
You trace your path next second.
It is a fundamental truth of Mordor. The orcs have been here far longer than men. Far longer than the Dark Lord himself, even. This place belongs to them. And in their own way, the orcs revere their heritage. We found this sword in a crude shrine, after all. Yet imagine what the orcs and Mordor could become if freed of the Dark Lord's corruption. Minas Ithil held many treasures far grander than this necklace, though none more precious to me. When I was a little girl, I would sneak into the Great Hall and take this necklace from its locked cabinet, thanks to a loose latch that only a child's hand could reach. For hours, I would admire myself in the mirror, imagining myself an elegant lady of Gondor, much like my mother must have been. My father caught me eventually, but as punishment, I received only a lecture. Perhaps he didn't mind seeing his daughter in such finery. The Analects of Ruvenir is a collection of advice from a long-ago Gondorian swordsman. It includes a series of exercises he guaranteed would lead to triumph in every duel. Like all young Gondorian soldiers, I studied the Analects a great deal, and I learned two key things. One, Ruvenir's swordsmanship was undoubtedly better than his penmanship. And two, in Ruvenir's time, duelists were far more courteous than the orcs of Mordor. War ignores such niceties.
Down.
Tahrir.
You ever get your top?
This statement of stewardship reads like a mundane description of lawmaking, but it is one of our most treasured documents. Gondor is a realm of law, not of kingly pronouncements. Since the disappearance of Eärnir, our last king, Gondor has thrived under the guidance of ruling stewards, each a lord of Minas Tirith. The steward's office is hereditary, and its decrees are law, unless a king someday returns to Gondor's vacant throne. And even then, I'm not sure what use we'd have for a monarch, save to keep the cushion on the throne warm.
Oh!